North Korean soldiers, a technicolor parading force against the West. On state-run television, a near ridiculous bravado of the military. But there are unseen soldiers in Kim Jong-un's cyber war versus the West. They have no face and only known by a number, Bureau 121.
What is Bureau 121?
They conduct the cyber attacks against overseas and enemy states, says Jang Se-yul. Jang is a North Korean defector, former Pyongyang military computer systems worker, now in South Korea, independently attempting to crumble an agency nearly impossible to chase. Bureau 121, a shadow agency with an unknown number of the regime's hand-picked shadow agents placed in countries around the world. Chang believes there are approximately 1,800 of them, though he says the agents themselves don't know how many exist. We can't verify Jang's claims about the shadow group, but he says he's obtained from a current operative hundreds of financial files, hacked from South Korean banks, complete with names and other bank account details.
Is the cyber war the real war for North Korea?
Raising cyber agents is fairly cheap, he says. The world has the wrong view of the North Korean state. With that incorrect worldview, North Korea was able to increase its ability to launch cyber attacks. South Korea learned the hard way. Banks across the country last year were paralyzed, ATMs frozen for days. Media outlets went dark, servers jammed or wiped. North Korea denied it was the source of a hack. But in the wake of the attack, South Korea beefed up its own cyber forces, declaring the online war as dangerous as Pyongyang's nuclear ambitions. North Korea exists in the land of over-the-top propaganda, while experts say it wages its parallel war in cyberspace, led by a young man of the internet age, ushering in a new phase of the Korean conflict. Kyung Lah, CNN, Seoul.